Imagine you're part of a team at a tech company. You're launching this brand new app that's going to revolutionize, I don't know, food delivery or something. The app is slick, the design is perfect, and customers are buzzing with excitement. But there's just one problem. Every time your developers finish coding a feature, it takes weeks to get it into production. And when it finally launches, something always breaks. Every single time. You've got developers on one side, super frustrated because their job is to build the app, not babysit it once it's running. And then you've got the operations teams, the folks who keep the servers and infrastructure running smoothly, on the other side, losing their minds because every update feels like a hand grenade getting tossed over the fence. They're constantly playing defense, trying to put out fires that they didn't even start. It's chaotic. Everything's a mess. And worst of all, customers are starting to notice. They're leaving bad reviews. They're deleting the app. Now, what if I told you this disaster could have been avoided? What if there was a way to get these two teams to stop fighting and start working together? Enter DevOps. All right, so here's the big question. What exactly is DevOps? People throw this term around like it's a magic wand that fixes all the software problems, but what does it actually do? On paper, DevOps is short for development and operations. It's kind of like a philosophy, a culture, or a mindset that bridges the gap between developers, the folks who write the code, and operations, the folks who make sure that code runs smoothly in the real world. But that sounds pretty vague, right? So let's break it down. Back in the day, like the early 2000s-ish, developers and operations teams worked in these totally separate silos. Developers would build their app, throw the code over to ops and say, here, make it work. And ops, who didn't have much insight into how the code was written, would try to get it up and running, often without a lot of context. The results? Bugs, outages, frustrated users, and a lot of finger pointing. So around 2007, 2008, people started asking, why are we doing it this way? Why are devs and ops acting like they're on different teams when we're all supposed to be working towards the same goal? This is where DevOps comes in. The idea is simple. Get developers and operations to collaborate early and often. Instead of waiting until the very end of development, think about your deployment and infrastructure. You bake it in from the start. This helps catch problems earlier, automate the boring stuff so humans aren't wasting time on repetitive tasks, and generally makes everything smoother. So what does this collaboration actually look like? Well, DevOps has a bunch of practices and tools that help break down the walls between dev and ops. You might have heard of these. Continuous integration, continuous delivery, CI/CD, infrastructure as code, automated testing, monitoring, and a lot more. For example, with CI/CD, every time a developer makes a change to the code, it's automatically tested and pushed to production in small increments, rather than saving it all for a massive release that could blow up in everyone's face. If something breaks, you know exactly what change caused it because you're shipping tiny updates, not big, scary ones. This keeps things stable and reduces those late-night emergency calls. Infrastructure as code is another big one. Instead of manually setting up servers, databases, and networks and hoping you didn't miss a step, ops teams write code that does all of this for them. It's repeatable, it's reliable, and if something goes wrong, you can track down the issue in the code rather than guessing what went wrong in, let's say, a sea of cables and machines. DevOps isn't just a set of tools. It's a way of working that changes how teams think about building and shipping software. It gets everyone on the same page, from dev to ops to even security teams, which, fun fact, is why sometimes you hear the term DevSecOps too. The whole point is to create a feedback loop where everyone's constantly learning, improving, and delivering value to customers faster, without the drama of constant firefighting. And when teams can do that, apps get shipped quicker, downtime drops, and customers are happier. So what's DevOps? It's like the glue that holds development and operations together, making sure everyone's working towards the same goal, delivering great software that actually works in the real world. It's a mindset, a process, and a set of tools all rolled into one. And in a world where speed and reliability are everything, it's kind of a big deal.